Hey folks, it's Dom here from Neighbourhood. Are you looking to gain a personalized, holistic view on how you're performing through HubSpot? Creating customer reports allows you to have greater flexibility in analyzing objects and activities inside your CRM, and today we're going to show you how. As a heads up, you'll need any of the HubSpot hubs at the professional or the enterprise level for these features. If you're keen on more practical support inside HubSpot, Neighbourhood offer a comprehensive, easy to follow course, so you're making the most out of what you've got. Stay tuned for more info at the end of this video. If you want to take your learning offline though, we'll include a downloadable PDF in the description below. So let's go into the reports section of HubSpot. If you go into the reports menu and then down to reports, this is where you'll be able to access all of the different reports that have been built. There is a range in here of reports that come from the report library, reports you've made yourself and others. Today we're going to focus on the custom reports, so just the ones that you make for yourself based on your own sort of data. The other thing you might be more familiar with potentially are dashboards. Dashboards are where reports live, so you can basically set up a dashboard and put up to 20 reports on it, custom or from the library, and then have a contained set of data or information that comes from a few different places, right? So you have a dashboard that has emails, landing pages, social media, all that sort of stuff all in one place. So you get an overarching view of all of your marketing efforts all in one place. So today, let's focus on the reporting. So let's go into reports. Let's go down, up into the top right here where it says create custom report. And then the first thing we have to do is make a choice. There are four different types of custom report. Today we're going to focus on single object and these custom reports. Funnels are relatively self-explanatory. It tracks how much or how many people move through a set of processes, or kind of like a set of checkpoints, and what the drop-off is at each of those checkpoints. So take, for example, a marketing funnel where you have your leads that then become opportunities that then become customers, something like that. So how many people started, how many people made it through to the middle, and how many people made it through to the end. That would be a funnel, and funnel reporting is going to help you with that. Attribution reporting is very complex. Attribution reporting breaks down what things within your HubSpot instance, or what sort of marketing tools, what sort of content you've created are influencing people who come into the system. So things like how much, what impact did an email have on your lead generation or on your customer generation, and how to define that numerically. Very complex. I'd recommend looking into some of the resources on HubSpot if you're more interested in attribution reporting. But let's start with single object. Single object allows you to take any of your objects in HubSpot, contacts, companies, deals, etc., and create reporting about that object specifically. On the other side of the coin, the custom report builder allows you to cross-reference objects. That's the main benefit it has. Let's start with one and then we'll come back around to the multiples. And let's start with contacts. The first thing you'll do is pick what data you want to pull from. As you can see on the left here, it's picked out two as an example. It's picked out create date and lifecycle stage as two regularly used fields that it think might be important. Let's add a few to that. So let's say, for example, things like, I'm going to put in here lead status. I'm also going to put in an example date field that I've added explicitly for this reason. So now we have a few different things in here that we are pulling from to build our report out of. You can only put things that you've added to the data into the report itself, so just keep that in mind. Once you're done with that, you can hit this visualization button and start building your report. So over here on the left, we have our options for how the chart looks. Things like your standard pie chart, bar chart, line chart, etc. There's also a table down here which can be very useful if you want to have more like a data set and report in that way, kind of like an Excel spreadsheet. Let's stick with the standard column chart for now. So let's start with a simple graph about the lead status. So let me pull the lead status option out of the data up here into this displaying area. And then we need something to count it against, like something to measure by. So let's use the count of contacts. So we want the number of people who have these lead statuses. And this is where the chart will show. You can see it's not showing anything just yet. That's because the filters are still in effect. So up here in the top left, you can see filters and then in brackets one. I open that up, it's got a create date filter, and it's only showing records that were created this quarter. We don't currently have any records created in this quarter in this account, so I'm going to change that to all time, update that filter, and you'll see that now we do have information here in this middle section. One thing you'll see immediately is that although there is information down here, 189 in new, 99 in open, 200 in open deal, it's being dwarfed by the number that are here in no value. So obviously this field is not one that we've used very comprehensively. to remove all of the ones that are showing here and kind of ruining our data, I'm gonna add a filter. I'm gonna add a filter for lead status specifically. And I want it to basically be anything that isn't no value. So it has to be known to get to make it onto the report. So if I add that filter, you can see it removes all of those unknown ones and just leaves me with some useful data. So now I have a report that shows what I'm looking for. It shows me the breakdown of the number of contacts in each of these levels. But we can get a little bit more specific. So let's do, if I add in start date, you see if I drag it up, it adds another section here. And now I'm able to start cross-referencing the information. So let's switch those around for a second. So what this is telling me is for each of our lead statuses, which are running down the bottom here, you can see new, open deal, unqualified, and then broken down by the date on which they started. And you can see each one of these zeros represents a date where no one is in that lead status. And then this one here, for example, does have people in, of a certain lead status in that date. So this here, now we're starting to cross-reference. If I would prefer to see this not laid out crossways, but maybe they're all like compiled on top of each other, stacked, I can do that by ticking the stacked button. That makes it a little bit cleaner. So now when I hover over it, I can see, okay, there are 100 people from the 21st of May, 2022. For this one here that has two options, I can see what those two options are. So that could be a good way to sort of cross-reference a few different things all on the same report. If I change my mind about how it's displaying, I can just switch it up here. So maybe I can go to a bar chart as opposed to a column chart. Maybe I can switch it to a pie chart and have a play with how it looks. Now, you'll note that with a pie chart, you are restricted. You can't go as deep as with the other charts. There's no second dimension you can put in, but still a useful way to convey information quickly. The other thing you can do is play with some of the timelines. So if I put this back to how it was a moment ago, and then I want to stack it. So it's stacked. Here you can see the frequency is currently set to daily. If I change that to be monthly, for example, that's all gonna change. And you can see here, they're all in May. So there might have been two dates, but they're in the same month. So it's changed it so that now we're seeing just that one month. If I make it weekly, then it might change back again. So yeah, you can see all of these ones here in the same week. And then this one here had some alternatives in a different week. So you can start to play with sort of the limits there. And that's kind of it. Once you're happy with the report you've done, hit save. Give it a name. So this is lead status by example date. Choose where you want it to show up. Do you want to add it to a dashboard here and now or not? If I say no, I don't want to add it to a dashboard, then it's going to double check who I want to be able to see it. If you do add it to a dashboard, it's just going to let everyone who can access the dashboard access the report. So the permissions for the dashboard overrule the report. If you don't pick a dashboard though, then you get to pick permissions for the report. So I'm just going to say this is available to everyone. Hit save. And it is created. If I back out to the reports page, there it is there, lead status by example date. Now, just to give you a quick glimpse into how that custom report builder is different, this here is a lot deeper of a tool. When I go in, I can start by saying what I want to look at. So let's start with contacts as our primary data source. That's the thing that we're reporting on. But now I can add in whole other objects as cross-references. So let's take, for example, companies, hit next. And so what I can do here and now is I can basically say, if I take a bar chart, same as we were using before, I'll make the same one that we were looking at in the last tool. So we wanna go lead status. We wanna go the count of contacts, and we wanna cross-reference it by their example date. I wanna add a filter, and I want that filter to be the lead status is known, apply. So we're starting to get towards what we were looking at before. I'm gonna change this from monthly to be daily. And now it should look a lot like what we were looking at in the last tool. There we go, slightly different colors, but same deal. What I can do is basically come over here to this menu over here on the left. You can see they're all laid out in order, so I can see contacts. If I keep scrolling down, I'll get to companies. Oh, actually, they're all contacts, sorry. if I change the breakdown to companies, then I can see companies. So these here are company fields. I can bring in some company fields as well. So let's say, for example, I want to, instead of breaking it down by start date, I'm going to instead break it down by the date the company was created. As you can see here, that's the report we just created, Lead Status by Example Date. If I click that, I can see the information on the report that we just created, exactly the same details. One of the cool things about reporting in HubSpot is because this is live and because it's attached to the CRM, I can do things like, let's say, for example, it's telling me there are 100 people that are open deals that were that have an example start date of the 9th of the 5th. If I click that, it'll give me a list of those people. So now I can scroll through those 100 people, see more information about them. It's pulling in all that information that we set up at the data stage. So if you remember, they had create date and lifecycle stage with the two pieces of data we started with, and then we added start date and lead status ourselves. So it brings any of the data points you have at that first stage of creating the report into this table, and you can see all of that whenever you click on any of the data. And there you have it. You now know how to build custom reports inside HubSpot. If you're wanting to make the most out of HubSpot, Neighbourhood offer a step-by-step course covering marketing, sales, service, and CMS Hub in depth, ensuring you and your team are best serving your customers while developing efficient internal processes. We'll include a link for this below. As well, if you gained value from this video or you're keen to learn more about HubSpot, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget, if you're after a PDF version of this for later or you're passing it on to a mate in need, we'll include a link in the description.